told me that you party with girls. I told her that I party with friends. Do you wanna talk to the girl?
Do you wanna talk to the girl?
She told me that you gotta have a rollie. Told me that you gotta have a Benz. If you wanna talk to the girl.
Hey loves, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, you're definitely welcome. So today's video, we're gonna be filming a makeup tutorial for you guys. This has been long way overdue. I'm sorry it took so long, but yes. So the hair I'm wearing in this video was sent to me by Sunber Hair Company. So they sent me a 26 inch and 228 inches of the Brazilian straight hair and a 20 inch lace closure. So basically they sent me this hair and then I made it into a wig myself. I used the hot glue gun method to actually make the wig just because I was so lazy to sew anything. So I just basically used the glue. So if you see any glue on my hair, guys, just ignore me. It was my first time, so you know. Prior to actually making this wig, I went ahead to bleach the lace front, the knots on the lace front, just to give it a more natural look. And before I actually wore this wig, like you guys already saw, I still went ahead to use my Laura Mercier Brown Setting Powder, just to, you know, give it some tint. Just because I wanted to give it a very, very natural look and everything blended in nicely. And then to install this wig, all I basically did was to apply my Got To Be styling gel, like you guys just saw. And best basically allowed it to dry a little bit and then just tuck this to my hairline. It's actually so easy to install compared to installing a lace frontal. For me, I don't know. So after installing the hair, I just went ahead to straighten it. Like you guys, this hair is so soft, so silky, and there was little to no shedding. The shedding was so minimal. The hair is actually so soft and it was so long. It went all the way to my below my booty, right under my bum. So after doing that and straightening the hair, I just went ahead with this Got To Be Free spray just to be able to, you know, seal down any flyaways that was in the middle parting. And I just patted, made sure my parting was very, very, very nice and neat. And then I went ahead to, you know, pluck out the excess hair that was in the middle of the parting just because I wanted it to look more like a natural part. And then I just laid my edges, you know, looking all flicky, girl. So I also wanted to add a little bit of sheen, so I went ahead with this olive oil sheen spray and just sprayed that to my hair, and that was it. I just put my hair in a little ponytail just so we can get onto the makeup part. So for my primer, I normally love to use this Hourglass mineral primer. It's a smoothing primer that's actually going to help to minimize the appearance of pores and just kind of blur all your imperfections and just make your face look very smooth, and also helps your makeup to last longer. So now I'm gonna go ahead to start off with my brows. So my brows have not changed the way I do my brows for the past, I don't know, 3 years. So basically I use a spoolie to brush my natural brow hair, and then I go ahead with this Anastasia Beverly Hills brow pomade and this little angle brush, and then I'm just gonna use that to fill my brows. Just take your time. After drawing my brows, I'm just gonna go ahead back to use the exact same spoolie that I used before, just to diffuse the effect so that the pigment of the brow is equal, so that some parts are not too dark and some parts are not too light. And then I'm gonna go ahead with this LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Toffee. If you're new to makeup, you wanna make sure that you're going one or maximum two shades lighter. If you go three shades lighter, girl, that's gonna be so hard for you to blend. So if you're, if you're just starting new into makeup and stuff, I'll recommend you just going one shade lighter, because that will be a lot easier for you to blend and, you know, minimize any possibility of having any harsh lines or anything like that. So after cleaning up my brows with this concealer, I'm gonna go ahead with this fluffy little brush to just blend that in. So now over to my eyelids, I'm gonna go ahead with this concealer. It's actually three shades lighter than my skin tone. The one I used for my eyebrow was two shades lighter. This one is three shades lighter. So I just wanted to use this to prime my eyelids or my eyeshadow and kind of give it a brightening look, because I have dark circles, so that kind of brightens my eye look. So now I'm gonna go ahead with this Juvia's Place palette, and in this palette I went ahead with that really, really light shade just to set the concealer. I'm gonna move to using the Soft Glam palette by Anastasia, and I'm gonna go ahead with this kind of light brown, but it's a little darker than the first one we used, and just kind of use that over my entire eyelids. Then I'm gonna go ahead with this orangey eyeshadow in the same palette that has more like a brownish undertone to it. And I'm just going to use that as well to, you know, as a transitioning shade for like my entire eyelid. Then after using that like orange shade, we're going to go ahead with this one that's a little bit darker but more on the brownie side, like taupe brown. And I'm just going to use that for the corner of my eye. So you want to make sure that as you're going darker, you're emphasizing more into like your, what's it called, your corner crease. So now I'm just gonna go ahead with this black color, like just a little bit. As you can tell, I changed my brush. This brush is way smaller and more precise. It's just gonna allow me to actually emphasize on that crease area without having to spread the black all over my eye. So it just, you know, keeps the pigment towards that corner. So now I'm gonna go ahead to actually cut my crease, and I'm gonna be using the same Other Girl Pro concealer that I use for my eyelid, and this is in the shade Warm Honey. So I'm just going to use that to cut my crease. You know, just take your time, do it slowly. Just make sure that, you know, when you're cutting your crease, you want to make sure that it's actually visible. So if you have like a more hooded eyes, or your eyelid space is very small, then you want to take your crease to be a little bit higher, like higher up. That's if you have hooded eyes. But if your eyes are just like mine, then you don't need to go too high. So now I'm going to go ahead with this MAC Fix Plus Setting Spray. I'm just going to go ahead to wet my brush just so I can pick up a lot more pigment. And then I use that same flat brush I just got wet to pick up this beautiful gold shimmer eyeshadow in this same palette. And just place that on the crease that you just cut. So basically on my eyelid space, like the lid. You have to make sure that your eyeshadow actually blends in properly. So we're gonna go back with this fluffy eyeshadow brush that we used the first time and just marry all the eyeshadow together. Make sure that the edges are actually very smooth. And then I went ahead with this Fenty Beauty ink eyeliner, and I just used that, you know, to make a little wing. I mean, that wasn't little, but you know, I just used that to do some wing. You don't have to do eyeliner if you really don't like eyeliner, because this part is something that I know that I've always struggled with, like eyeliner. It took me forever to get here, sis. Like, you don't even understand. So I'm going to go ahead with these eyelashes. These are some random lashes I got from Aliexpress. Like, they were literally like $1 per pair. So, girl, you don't even really have to spend your whole bank account trying to buy any lashes. And these lashes have lasted me for the past 4 months, and they're not even dead yet, so they are still working very effectively. So now I'm gonna go ahead to do my foundation, and I'm gonna be using the Estee Lauder Doublewear foundation in the shade 6C2. As you can tell, this foundation is a little bit red for my face. However, my neck is actually very, very dark and pretty, like more like a reddish undertone. So I like to make sure that my foundation blends with my neck rather than my face, because my face is a little lighter than my neck. So if I actually blend to my face, they're looking like Adanna on the face and Genevieve on the neck. Which is not what I'm trying to achieve over here. So now I'm going to go ahead with this Tarte Shape Tape Concealer, and this is in the shade Deep. I'm just going to go ahead to conceal under my eyes, my forehead, my nose, and the rest of my face that needs to be brightened up a little bit. And then I went ahead with my damp beauty blender that I use for my face and just use that to blend in my concealer. You don't want to stretch your concealer too wide. Like, if you're stretching your concealer too much to the side, that means you're trying to expand your face. But if you want to keep your face to be smaller, then you want to keep your concealer to be just right under your eyes and not flatten it out to your entire, I don't know if that even makes sense, but yeah. So now I'm gonna go ahead to set my concealer using my Laura Mercier setting powder, and then I'm gonna go back with this Fenty Beauty liquid eyeliner just to put some on my, what's it called, these things are so hard to remember, like my eyeline thing. So I'm just gonna put some there, and then I went ahead to use this Nars Kohl liner, and so I just used that to darken my eyeline. And then I also went ahead to tight line my waterline, so basically to put the eyeliner under my eyes. It's actually gonna help to make your lashes look very full, and so when you look up, you don't look like you have two different pigments going on at the top and at the bottom, you know. God, this place is so hot, like these lights make me sweat. So now I'm gonna go back to the same eyeshadow palette. One thing about makeup, whatever I do to the top, you have to do to the bottom. Whatever you do to the right, you have to do to the left. So now that we are done with the top part of the eyes, I went back to, you know, do the same thing I did with the top to the bottom. So in this case, I went ahead to use this black eyeshadow, first of all, to smudge that on my lower waterline. And then I went back to use that reddish dark burgundy that we used. Remember, we used that on the top of our eyelid. So now we're going to use that at the bottom just to smudge that out. And then I'm going to go ahead with my mascara. And for the mascara, I'm using the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara, and then for my contour, girl, this is the most exciting part of makeup for me. My contour, I normally use the Makeup Forever Stick foundation in the shade R540 because I don't like my contour to be that wow, like I want it to be here. So I'm gonna go ahead to contour under my cheekbones and basically every area of your face that you want to put some shade to, your nose, you know, just make sure those areas that you want to make it look slimmer, that's where you're gonna contour. So for my blush, I went ahead to use the ColourPop Super Shock Cheek Blush in the shade Cheerio. And then I'm going to go to the highlights, baby girl. So I'm using the Fenty Beauty highlight in the shade Mean Money Hustler Baby. And this is just going to go right on your cheekbones. So any area of your face that you want to emphasize. So your cheekbones, your forehead, the nose, you know, your chin. Girl, we're going to be popping. Hey. Whenever I'm going for like a night event, I want to make sure that my highlight is blinding the DJ. So I normally go ahead with this Artist Couture highlight to add some extra pigments, and this is in the shade Conceited. And then now I'm gonna go ahead to line my lips. For my lips, I'm just use this random brown lip liner that I always use. I don't even know where I got it from. I think it's from back home. Yeah, from back home. So I'm gonna use that to line my lips. And then after lining my lips, I went ahead with this Kat Von D liquid matte lipstick in the shade Flat. It's more like a brownish undertone but a little bit of red in it. So I went ahead to use that on my lip. And over top, I'm gonna go ahead. Oh, one sec, I think my highlight has not yet finished. So I'm gonna highlight my brow bone just so my brows can pop. Okay, back to the lips. So I'm gonna be using this Fenty Gloss Balm lip gloss. I don't know if I even said gloss 5 times. So I'm gonna put this on my lips. And then when I applied this lip gloss, I realized that it was too warm for my eyes. So I went ahead with this ColourPop lip gloss that has more of a pinkish, orangey undertone. So just, you know, cool my lip down a little bit. It was just too warm, it was too brown. So I just put that lip gloss over top, and that's basically it. Like, that is the look. So I'm gonna go ahead to put some highlight on my tear duct. You know, you want your eyes to be popping. Like, this is a night event. Like, people need to see my highlights. First of all, I'm short, so I need to emphasize my face. So after doing this, I'm gonna go ahead to use my MAC Fix Plus setting spray and just set my entire face. And girl, that is the entire look. Every product I use in this video will be down below in the description box. The hair, the makeup, the highlights, everything. For my hair, I went ahead to use my foundation just, you know, to emphasize my middle part. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you did, don't forget to give me a big thumbs up, comment, share, subscribe. And I will see you guys next weekend. I love you guys so much. Have a wonderful, wonderful week. Bye. Mwah. It's fake kills. Original. Puffing on me high grade, sipping on me liquor. Girls, them I come, them I want, them I take her. Bad man, me I come in, me I wanna take her. Girls, them I come, them I want in on the liquor. I steady sipping on my liquor. Then I tell her me she give her, never trust another nigga.